When doing improper integrals, we've been worried about what is the value of a particular integral. But in many cases, the big question isn't what is the value, but does it even have a value? Does the integral converge or does it diverge? In a few weeks, when we start doing sequences in series, we're going to spend an incredibly large amount of time talking about determining whether things converge or diverge. And one of the most powerful techniques we're going to have is going to be comparison tests. So what I want to do is I want to show you how a comparison test works for improper integrals. If you understand how it works for improper integrals, you'll have a pretty easy time doing comparison tests for sequences in series. So here's a comparison test. Let's suppose we've got two positive functions. Let's call them f of x and g of x. But g of x is the big one and f of x is the little one. And we want to compare the integrals. We want to look at the integral, improper integral of f of x from a to infinity, where a is some number, and the improper integral of g of x. And the rule is, if the smaller one diverges, then the bigger one also diverges. If the bigger one converges, then the smaller one converges. So by comparing two things, if you're we like to think of smaller as being better, because the smaller it is, the smaller the integral it is, the more likely it is to converge. So if the good one fails, if the little guy diverges, then the big guy diverges. If the big guy converges, then the little guy is even better, and it converges. So for example, we know that the integral from 1 to infinity of 1 over x to the fourth converges. We did that one in the last video. We did it for p in general, but we saw that for p bigger than 1, it converges. Happens to converge to 1/3. And we know that 1 over x to the fourth plus 1 is less than 1 over x to the fourth. So the integral of 1 over x to the fourth plus 1 dx has got to converge. Now, we don't know what it converges to. I mean, you can do this integral using partial fractions, but it's really ugly. You don't want to go there. So you don't know what it converges to, but you know that it converges because by comparison to 1 over x to the fourth. So why does a comparison test work? Well, let's let big F of t be the indefinite integral of little f. Okay? So big F of t is all of the area from a to t. Now, as t gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, you pick up more and more and more area. So F of t is an increasing function. Incidentally, by the fundamental theorem of calculus, the derivative of big F is little f, and that's positive. So that's another way to see that it's an increasing function. So if you've got something that's getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and remember, we're trying to figure out the limit of this guy. By definition, the integral from 0 to infinity of f of x dx is the limit as t goes to infinity of f of t. So we want to see what happens to big F of t as t goes to infinity. Well, it's increasing, so it can't oscillate. The only two things it can do is easy. It can either top out and approach a certain limiting value, or it can keep growing and growing and growing and go to infinity. Those are the only two possibilities. There's a fancy name for this. It's called monotonic convergence. We'll get that when we get sequences in series. And likewise, if you take big g of t, which is the indefinite integral of little g of x dx, well, this integral is bigger than this integral, because if this is the curve y equals f of x, over here we've got the curve y equals little g of x. So there's more area under the g curve than there is under the f curve. So big g is bigger than big f. So if this is going to infinity, and this is bigger than it, then it's going to infinity. On the other hand, if this guy isn't going to infinity, it's bounded, well then this has to be bounded as well. And that's the comparison test. Okay, final thing about improper integrals, which is don't forget to use L'Hôpital's rule. There are times when you can do an improper integral by basically just plugging in at the endpoints. So we did the integral of 1 over root x dx, and we got that was 2 root x evaluated at 1 and at t. And how do you take the limit as t approaches 0? Well, you just plug in 0. So we could have done it just like this and said integral of 1 over root x is 2 root x, plug in 1 and at 0, and you're done. On the other hand, there are integrals where this doesn't make sense. If you want to integrate x e to the minus x dx, well, this requires integration by parts, and the antiderivative of x e to the minus x is minus x plus 1 e to the minus x. And if you try plugging that in at 0 and at infinity, it doesn't make sense. You get minus infinity e to the minus infinity. You don't know what that means. You have to take t, and then to evaluate that integral, you apply L'Hôpital's rule. So in this case, L'Hôpital's rule, this is an infinity times 0 kind of situation. So you put this in the denominator to turn it into an infinity over infinity situation, and then you can take the derivative of the top, the derivative of the bottom, and now you've got a limit that goes to 0. So in lots and lots of situations involving improper integrals, you've got to take the limit as t goes to 0, or t goes to 3, or t goes to infinity, or t goes to minus infinity, and the key tool for doing that is L'Hôpital's rule. If L'Hôpital's rule is not familiar to you, go back to the right section and the right learning module and review it. It's going to come up a lot when we do sequences in series.